Hello again. So we've seen the Scimitar, we've seen the Strafe. Now I'm joined by Joshua, our global audio PM, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the Void. Josh, what's going on with these headphones?
Well, we've been working on this for a long time. We actually wanted to bring a design from scratch and do it all ourselves. So we wanted to refresh all of our wireless, our USB, and our regular analog stereo headsets with a new design, have all new features.
Tell me a little bit about the design.
Well, I guess the thinking of it is that we wanted something to be very iconic and identifiable. Everybody streams and wants to have something very distinctive mm-hmm. to wear, but we also wanted it to be uber comfortable. This is a actually smaller looking headset than our last one, but it's actually a lot more comfortable because we've really kind of adjusted the ear cup shape to look like a human ear. So this has tracks the human ear shape very, very well. And you know, whether you're wearing glasses or earrings or studs or whatever, it has an extremely comfortable shape. But this also fits in with the RGB family. So this is our first headset that has RGB power behind it.
So along with the Scimitar and the Strafe, this has got some programmable lighting effects as well.
So it has the Q-Link. So if you want to sync up between all of your devices, really like a one-touch thing, it's not only the color, but also kind of what's going on. So we have a dynamic lighting system in all of our products now. So if it's flashing really quick, or if it's just like a slow breathe or pulse or whatever, you can sync everything with one touch.
This is the wireless one. The USB is obviously powered ad infinitum.
Yep.
But one of the things I noticed was that there was no dongle to control the sound.
Oh, yeah.
On the USB.
The nice thing about USB is that we brought all the controls up to the headset, so there's not like that dongle that's sort of kind of hard to, where is it again?
Okay.
And you know, it's always right in the same spot. So the controls of the headset are always going to be on the left side. We've got a new control called the Q control that has a kind of a push button feature, so we can digitally dial our volume up or down and then toggle the EQ modes or turn on and off Dolby.
Oh wow.
You can do all that just through one little control.
This is all done on the headset, not in any kind of visual interface.
There's actually a kind of a corresponding visual interface on the front of the mic, and if you see kind of these lights on the front, this is what we call InfoMic. So there's a couple of LEDs, and the back one's multicolor, and the front one's a dedicated mute light.
Okay.
The back one, it'll tell you what Dolby state you're on, what EQ mode you're on, if you're running low on power. Like a wireless headset usually doesn't tell you it's dying until the last minute, right?
Yeah. Well, what is the battery life of this guy?
Our last headset, I'd say arguably lasted maybe 10-12 hours. But this one, we have all these lights on it, so we had to boost up the battery power. The capacity of the battery is a lot more. So even with all the lights, we're getting a good 60% improvement up to 16. But if you're not, you know, if you're maybe somebody like me, I don't really need the fancy lights, I can turn that down, you're gonna get almost 20.
That is pretty cool. Well, I don't really have any other questions for Joshua, but if you guys have questions, please make sure you leave them in the comments below. And make sure you subscribe as well, because we don't want you to miss out on any more cool videos. Thanks again for joining us.
Thanks,
Joshua, thank you for taking the time out to talk to us.
See you later.